is how to find Glenn Gould's grave. You're in Mount Pleasant Cemetery. There's this plot number 40, which is kind of round. And it says number 40. And it goes sort of, it's a roundabout. So once you get there, turn around and you'll see this rock. Then you're going to see here the Chan family. Nice grave. Now walk towards the Chan family and cross over to the left. And you know you're getting close to Glenn Gould when you have a name like Bell. You know the sound is going to be getting good. So you keep going and going. Then you see Fairbanks and you think, oh, wasn't that a name of an actor from a long time ago? And we keep going. Where is this Glenn Gould grave? Turn left again. Keep going. We're not getting any closer. Was there any help? But yes, look. You find there's a gentleman. So Glenn Gould must be near. So, let's cross over the gentleman. And finally, we see, imagine if your last name was Coffin. Wow, Leonard R. Coffin. Makes me think Leonard R. Cohen. But you know you're very close to Glenn Gould when that happens. Because you look straight ahead, and you're on your way to see his marker. There it is, Glenn Gould, 1932 to 1982. And you can see the opening of the famous Goldberg Variations, his signature work, interpretation of Bach. And that's Glenn Gould, and you see someone put some nice flowers here. There's a little marker at night for light. And there's the headstone of his mother, beloved wife, and father. So we cross up and we see the dearly loved son, Glenn H. Gould, October 4th, 1982. Now the interesting thing is, right in the top, there's a turtle. They say Glenn always did like animals. Well, there's a turtle. I wonder what its name is. Is it Stravinsky? Is it, I don't know.
Bach and Gould are just about the coolest dudes. Glenn has wheels and a Lincoln Continental. Bach is working on his next instrumental, and it's certainly a different type of fugue. And it's certainly a different type of fugue.